bold and dynamic, innovative, art that beautifully blends generations. Ancient art from the Near East, paintings, sculptures, artifacts, specimens of natural history. The Hood Museum at Dartmouth College boasts 70,000 pieces of art in its historic collection. And the very first item acquired back in 1771, this massive tooth belonging to a creature that is now extinct.
The very first thing was given to the college 2 years into the college's history, and it's the tooth of a woolly mammoth. The museum has been totally transformed. We went from 11 galleries to 16 galleries, and every single gallery has been reconsidered. We've rearranged the entire way the story of art is told.
Museum director John Stomberg oversaw the three-year, $50 million renovation of the Hood, the process that began back in 2015.
We had a lot of trouble with people finding the museum in our past. Now we've got a bold facade right on the campus, and it's at street level, so you can walk right in. It's architecture that reads, "Come on in."
And when you walk on in, you are greeted with brilliant, eye-catching works of art, like this wall piece put together by a Nigerian artist. Look closely. You will see the use of aluminum bands that surround liquor bottles, creating this giant quilt of art.
On one level, it's abstract art. If you look at it visually, it's got beautiful patterns, stripes, and colors, and it is really terrific, and the artist likes to start there, but the artist goes much deeper. The fact that they're alcohol bottles, he finds a reference to both the triangle trade, where enslaved Africans were traded for molasses, which was traded for rum, and the rum found its way back to Africa and led to alcoholism problems. It's literally taking trash and turning it into art, which is a hopeful message for the future of the world.
The Hood Museum is named after Harvey P. Hood, class of 1918, and a member of the Hood family dairy in Massachusetts. The museum opened in 1985, but the prestigious Ivy League school began collecting artwork long before a museum was even a thought.
Dartmouth's collections go all the way back to 1772, so that's before the founding of our country, actually.
Juliet Bianco is the deputy director of the Hood Museum. She says having such a broad collection coming together now in this newly expanded space provides an educational opportunity, not just for Dartmouth students, but for all visitors, especially younger children from area schools who visit the museum on a regular basis.
We hope that every time someone comes to the museum, and we hope people come often, they're going to see something new, a new collection, a new object, a new acquisition, a new interpretation, and hopefully bring something away with them that they either didn't expect or that they're surprised by.
More gallery space allows the Hood to showcase more of its collection. Only a fraction of the 70,000 pieces can be featured at one time.
At this point, we have about 1% of our collection on display, but we're committed to changing over the galleries on the regular basis.
Dartmouth College was founded in 1769 as an institution to educate Native Americans. You feel that culture very present at the Hood.
Especially in the Native American galleries, we carry the story from the earliest objects we have all the way into the contemporary. It's very important for our presentation of Native American art and culture that the story is robust and vibrant today as it was earlier in history. And we now have a Native American Studies department, and we have staff, students, and faculty, all of whom identify as Native American. And here at the museum, as a reflection of that, the only full department that we have is actually Native American art.
The Hood is a teaching museum, and the new facility boasts three new classrooms, allowing students to directly engage with the art. Eliza Whittemore is an art history major and a senior. When she arrived in 2015, the Hood was already shut down. She could only study and see the artifacts online.
With modern technology, you can see the Hood's collection online, which is a huge benefit, especially during Reconstruction, but it's not the same as really being able to get up and close and personal with the works and being able to write about them and discuss them. something caught my eye and I recognized it from online, and it just looks so different in person, and it's really much more fantastic.
There is the traditional artwork, like Picasso's Guitar on a Table, an exhibition of photography put together by Dartmouth College students, and this, a V12 Mercedes engine, a reflection of the ingenuity of craftsmen in the North African country of Morocco.
There's over 350 parts to this motor, and each one has been lovingly recreated in the material that that craftsman works in, whether you're a leathersmith, a wood carver, or a bronze caster. And then it's all been put together, so it is now, it's gone from being a motor to being an artifact in a way.
And this sculpture, the crankcase from that same Mercedes.
This, believe it or not, does collapse back in and becomes a fully operational crankcase which joins to the motor. So it's all handmade, it's all beautifully crafted, and the artistic conceit is, what if we could have craftspeople take over mass production?
Galleries, 70,000 pieces in Dartmouth's collection. John Stomberg says the hood represents art around the world and through time. Whether you are an art scholar or a novice, there's something at the new Hood Museum that will attract visitors of all ages.